A very good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Singaram. Today, I'll be discussing a very important topic for your competitive exams, university exams, or clinical vivas, that is about breastfeeding and breast milk. Any level, one question is definitely expected from this topic. Breast milk is an ideal food for the neonates, and it is the best gift a mother can give to her baby. To get started with this topic, let us answer this question. When should the breastfeeding be initiated? Even though the guidelines say that it has to be initiated within 1 hour of birth, the answer ideally should be as early as possible. Right? As early as possible. Then coming to the definition, does the baby require any other feeding? No, it is only breastfeeding a baby requires till the first 6 months. What is the meaning of this exclusive breastfeeding? Exclusive breastfeeding means only breastfeeding, not even water or any other form of food for that matter. Why not even water? Because remember, breastfeeding is 90% of breast milk is nothing but water. So when a baby is exclusively breastfeeding, baby does not require water. Okay, that should be remembered. However, if you are giving some medications to the baby, or it's a preterm baby or a low birth weight baby which requires multivitamin supplementation, that is included under the definition of exclusive breastfeeding. Now, what is this exclusive? Exclusivity is only to the feeding. So, exclusive breastfeeding means only breastfeeding without any other form of feed. Okay, right. Now, what is this complementary feeding? Complementary feeding is started after 6 months, wherein along with the breastfeed, you also have to give other nutritional substances. That's called as complementary feeding. Now, if they ask you the question, when are you going to continue breastfeeding? Breastfeeding is ideally continued till the age of 2 years. Why till 2 years? Even some mothers are continuing beyond 2 years also, but minimum we tell the mothers to continue breastfeeding till 2 years. Why 2 years? I'll be telling you under the properties of breast milk. To help in the process of breastfeeding, there are some maternal reflexes as well as the reflexes in the baby. First, let us see the maternal reflexes. There are two important reflexes mediated by the pituitary hormones. What are they? One is the prolactin reflex. The other one is called as the oxytocin reflex. First, let us look at what is the role of prolactin. The role of the prolactin is something like production. You can just remember PRO for PRO. What is that? PRO for production. So prolactin is for production of the breast milk. Okay, right. In other words, they can put it up like this. It is called as galactopoiesis. Poiesis means production, galacto means milk. So it is called as galactopoiesis. So prolactin is important for galactopoiesis. Now, when the baby sucks, the nerve ending in the nipple carry the impulses to the anterior pituitary, which in turn release prolactin, and this prolactin will act on the glands in the breast to stimulate milk production. This is called as galactopoiesis. A very important point is, more the baby sucks at the breast, the greater is the milk production. So that is why baby sucking has got a very important part in prolactin. The second point to be remembered is that prolactin is secreted more during night time. Is it not? You all know the normal physiology. So that is why a mother should never skip nighttime breastfeeding. Otherwise, this prolactin reflex will get weakened. That should be remembered. The second hormone which is important in the process of breastfeeding is oxytocin. What is the role of this oxytocin? Oxytocin is for milk ejection. It is for ejection of already present milk in the breast. Okay. In other words, we can put it like this. It is a movement of the milk from the mother's breast to the baby. So it's called as a galactokinesis. You all know that kinesis means movement. So this is galactokinesis. Now, a very important point to be remembered is that this oxytocin reflex is very, very dependent on maternal emotions. Please note, it is dependent on maternal emotions. So a mother who is relaxed will have a good oxytocin reflex and will have a good breastfeeding. Okay. But if the mother is tensed, okay, she's having lack of confidence to breastfeed, then obviously this oxytocin reflex will not be that strong and she will have difficulty in breastfeeding. This should be remembered. There are three important reflexes in the baby. The first and foremost is the rooting reflex. What is this? When the cheek or the side of the baby's mouth is touched, the baby opens the mouth and searches for the mother's nipple. This is called as a rooting reflex. So basically, what is the purpose of this rooting reflex? It helps in proper attachment of the baby to the mother's breast. This should be remembered. Right. What is the next one? Next one is the sucking reflex. Now, sucking reflex happens when the baby's palate is touched with the mother's nipple. Once that nipple touches the baby's palate, the baby immediately starts the process of sucking. And once the mouth is full, what will happen? The baby will start swallowing. That is what we call it as a swallowing reflex. A very, very important point to be noted is that this suckling and swallowing should always be coordinated with breathing. And that is what we call it as a suckle, swallow, breathe reflex. And you should know what is the approximate time for one cycle of this suckle, swallow and breathe. It approximately lasts for 1 second, and that is also a question sometimes asked in your exams. Here comes a very important point for you to know about. What is this? This is nipple confusion. Nipple confusion is seen when the baby is given bottle feeds. This is a very important point. It's seen in a bottle fed baby. Why this is seen? Because remember, a baby who is sucking from the bottle is like a passive process. It is a passive form of sucking. Whereas when the baby is sucking from the mother's breast or breastfeeding, is an active process which requires effort from the baby. So it's an active process. So naturally, when the baby is given both breastfeeding as well as bottle feeding, after some time the baby starts refuse to feed on the breast because it's an active process. So baby prefers only bottle feeding. This is what we call it as nipple confusion. So that is why even a single session of bottle feeding will lessen the chance of a successful breastfeeding. So that is why bottle feed at any cost should be avoided. Having talked about the basics of breastfeeding, let's move on to the most important part, that is the properties of breast milk. Remember, breast milk is not only for nutrition, it is also for immunological advantages. So that is why it is often said that breastfeeding is the number one intervention to decrease the death in the newborn period. Please remember, because of the immunological advantages present in the breast milk. The first one undoubtedly for your exams to be known is IgA. Breast milk is a rich source of IgA. What is that IgA? Yes, it is secretory IgA. Because it is secreted in the breast milk, it's called secretory IgA, which is obviously going to protect the baby from so many infections. Now, next one is some important other immunological substances present in the breast milk you need to know about. The first one is called paraminobenzoic acid, which protects the baby from malaria infections. Then lactoferrin and bifidus factor, which protects the baby from bacterial infection, especially E. coli infection. Then bisalt stimulated lipase. This is going to protect the baby from parasitic infection, especially giardiasis as well as amoebiasis. Okay, but most important you need to know is giardiasis as well as amoebiasis also it protects. Okay. Then there are something called as a bioactive factors, or simply remembered as growth factors in the breast milk. What are the growth factors? They are the transforming growth factor and epidermal growth factor, which actually promotes the growth of intestinal epithelium. Right, it is very easily understandable because the breast milk is going to reach the intestinal epithelium. It's going to promote the growth of intestinal epithelial cells. Why this is very important? Because it improves the process of digestion as well as it is said to decrease the risk of allergy in the later life. Right? That is about the immunological advantages. We now move on to the nutritional properties of breast milk. What is this amount of energy which is derived from 100 ml of breast milk? It's a very standard question. Please remember, it is 67 kilocalories per 100 ml. That is a standard answer which all of you should be knowing by heart. Let us look at little bit in depth about the nutrition advantages in the form of carbohydrate, protein and fats. Remember, carbohydrates, most of the carbohydrate in the breast milk is nothing but lactose. You all know that lactose is going to divide into glucose and galactose. What is the importance of this lactose? One is for generation of glucose. Second is that lactose is going to promote the growth of a good bacteria in the gut. What is that? Lactobacilli. Correct. Second important carbohydrate present in the breast milk, which you need to know about, is something called as a galactocerebroside. As the name suggests, it is very important in the brain, where it helps in the process of myelination. So it's called as galactocerebroside. That is also present in the breast milk. The next one you need to know about is regarding the proteins. Now, please remember, when we talk about the proteins, breast milk is said to be a whey predominant formula. Or the type of protein which is predominant in the breast milk is whey protein. Okay, we always compare it with other protein. What is that? Casein. Casein is predominant in the cow milk. Casein is predominant in the cow milk. Right? You can just remember like this. C for casein and C for the cow milk. Please remember which is better type of protein. It is undoubtedly the whey protein, which is a better type of protein. And that is present in the breast milk. What are the examples of this whey protein? The examples of this whey protein are the lactoalbumin and lactoglobulin, chiefly lactoalbumin and lactoglobulin. They are the predominant whey proteins. What is the importance of this whey protein? They are going to promote the brain growth. Very, very important point, and that is why they are of nutritional importance as well as for growth of the brain. Okay. Second point to remember is that whey proteins are easily digested compared to the caseins. Right. Now, next point I would want you to remember is that breast milk also contains certain amino acids, namely taurine and cysteine. Why should we know about these two important amino acids? Is because these two amino acids also promote the brain growth. So please remember, whey protein, taurine and cysteine, they are going to promote the brain growth. On the other hand, casein, as I have previously told you, is predominant in the cow milk and it is not easily digestible. Second point is that the casein component in the cow milk actually predisposes to the development of allergy, and that is what we call it as a cow milk protein allergy. This needs to be remembered. So coming to the next point about fats in the breast milk, please remember, breast milk is rich in polyunsaturated fatty acid, especially docosahexaenoic acid, DHA, as well as arachidonic acid. Why should you know about this point? Because this DHA and arachidonic acid are very, very important for myelination or brain growth. Please make a note of it. Okay, so I have told you during this discussion that there are substances which are promoting the brain growth, starting from this galactosidibroside for myelination, whey protein, two important amino acids, taurine and cysteine. Now I have told you about polyunsaturated fatty acids also. All of them promote brain growth. You all know that brain attains 90% of the adult size by the age of 2 years. So that is why, if you remember in the first part of discussion, I told you, you have to continue breastfeeding till the age of 2 years. One of the most important reasons being undoubtedly brain growth. This has to be explained to the mother, and you have to convince the mother to make her breastfeed till the age of 2 years. This is for brain growth. What are the other benefits of breastfed babies? Because the brain growth is better, it results in a higher IQ compared to the non-breastfed babies. Number two is that there is decreased incidence of necrotizing enterocolitis in preterm babies. There is decreased incidence of sudden infant death syndrome in the neonatal period. Third point is that beyond the neonatal period also, breastfed babies have a decreased risk of developing diabetes, heart disorders, as well as one important cancer, which is lymphoma. This can be asked in your exams. Please make a note of it. Right. Now, breast milk is not only advantageous for the baby, it is also advantageous for the mother. What way? It decreases the risk of postpartum hemorrhage. How this is going to happen? This is because under the influence of oxytocin, there is uterine involution, right? This is going to decrease the risk of postpartum hemorrhage. Second is, prolactin will cause suppression of ovulation. And this is what is prolactin is going to cause suppression of ovulation, and this is what is going to result in lactational amenorrhea. Okay, this is going to suppress the ovulation, and that is going to result in lactational amenorrhea. It is said that if the mother has been exclusively breastfeeding her babies and not resumed the menses, then there is no need for any other contraception during the initial 6 months of delivery. This is called as lactational amenorrhea. And breastfeeding also decreases the risk of two important cancer in the breast, and this is very important question they can ask you. What are they? One is, it decreases the risk of breast cancer. Second, it decreases the risk of ovarian cancer in the mother. Right. This needs to be remembered. We have talked so much about the advantages of breast milk. You should also know there are some deficiencies in the breast milk, especially with reference to the vitamin. The most important vitamin which is deficient in the breast milk is vitamin K. So that is why at the birth itself we give an injection of vitamin K into the anterolateral aspect of the thigh in newborn babies. Second is vitamin D, especially in the Indian continent. So that is why we are giving additional supplementation of vitamin D to all breastfed babies. Third is, if the mother is strictly vegetarian mother, okay, there is vitamin B12 deficiency also, and all these needs to be supplemented. Right. Now, next important point is iron. Please remember, the iron content of the breast milk is low. It's a fact. But the point to be remembered is that there is a better bioavailability due to better absorption of iron from the breast milk when compared to the cow milk. So that is why, okay, iron need not be routinely supplemented to the newborn babies who are breastfeeding. Second point to be remembered is that newborn babies also have adequate amount of iron stores, which will prevent them from developing iron deficiency anemia. So there is no routine need for supplementation of iron. However, vitamin K, vitamin D, all of them have to be supplemented. And if the mother is strictly vegetarian, vitamin B12 also has to be supplemented. What are the names given to the breast milk which is secreted after birth? The first 3 days is what we call as the colostrum. What is the importance of the colostrum? Colostrum is rich in immunoglobulin A. That needs to be remembered. After 3 days till 2 weeks or 14 days is what we call it as a transitional milk. Nothing much to be remembered here. Only thing to be noted is that the fat as well as the sugar content of the milk increases at this time, whereas the protein content of the milk decreases at this time. This needs to be remembered. It's called as transition milk. And after 14 days is what we call it as a mature milk. Now look at this picture. The first picture, which is more whiter and thinner, is called as a fore milk. And the second picture, which is more thicker and slightly yellowish, is what we call it as a hind milk. Fore milk is the first part of the milk which comes out. Hind milk is the last part of the milk. What you need to remember is fore milk is rich in water. It is almost full of water only. Okay, even though it contains protein, sugars as well as vitamins, but it is rich in water is the point to be remembered. So what does it do? It will satisfy the baby's thirst. Right. Hind milk, the point to be remembered is that it is rich in fat. Fat are the richest source of energy, right? So that is why hind milk actually provides more energy, and it actually gives a sense of satiety to the baby. This needs to be remembered regarding fore milk and hind milk. A baby requires both fore milk and hind milk. Therefore, the baby should be allowed to empty out one breast completely before switching over to the other breast. Now, something regarding the positioning during breastfeeding. Mother can assume any posture which is comfortable for her, which could be lying down or sitting upright. Okay. Position of the baby also should be in such a way that the whole body of the baby should be supported and baby's head turned towards the mother. Or in other words, abdomen of the baby and the mother should be touching each other. Equally important and even more important to be remembered is that signs of good attachment, what we also call it as latching. This is a very, very important. I have given you the picture also. Please remember what is called as correct attachment or latching. Now, what are the signs of good attachment? Okay, what is given in the first two upper pictures are the signs of good attachment. You can see that the baby's mouth should be wide open. Most of the areola and nipple should be inside the baby's mouth. Very, very important point. If at all some part of the areola is visible, upper areola may be visible, but lower areola should always be inside the baby's mouth. We will tell why this point is important with reference to a condition which I am going to discuss later. Third point is baby's chin should be touching the mother's breast, and baby's lower lip as well as the upper lip, both the lips of the baby should be everted. Okay, these are the signs of good attachment. Please be very, very sure in this. You should know this, and you should also explain to the mothers whenever you give a counseling session regarding breastfeeding. Now, talking about some contraindications of breastfeeding, first, let us discuss, and what is important is to know about absolute contraindication for breastfeeding. Absolute contraindication for breastfeeding is, one is in the baby, wherein the baby suffers from some inherited metabolic condition, which includes lactose intolerance or galactosemia. The baby cannot digest the lactose and galactose, right? So that is why it is absolutely contraindicated. Lactose intolerance and galactosemia. And talking from the maternal point of view, mother is on chemotherapeutic medications or on radiotherapy, then she is not going to breastfeed the baby. So these are the absolute contraindications for breastfeeding. The other ones are more of a relative contraindication, I would put it like that. This includes a group of infections. Okay, worldwide HIV infection, okay, or in developed countries, HIV infection in the mother is absolute contraindication for breastfeeding. But in India, mother can breastfeed the, we're talking about the maternal infection, mother can breastfeed the baby. Only thing is that she should be taking antiretroviral therapy and the baby should be taking prophylaxis. That needs to be remembered. Second is tuberculosis. Tuberculosis, again, it is not primarily spread via breast milk, but the point to be remembered is that if the mother is an untreated case of tuberculosis, or if she has taken treatment but the treatment duration is less than or equal to 2 weeks, okay, right, then also it's a contraindication for breastfeeding, because at the time of breastfeeding she can likely to transmit it to a baby via the respiratory droplet. So less than 2 weeks treatment or untreated, okay, she is not allowed to directly breastfeed the baby. Third is, of course, the lesions in the breast, for example, herpetic lesions or the chickenpox lesions in the breast region, then also she is not allowed to directly breastfeed the child. Okay, so these are more of a relative contraindication, but what you need to know from the exam point of view is the absolute contraindications for breastfeeding. The next aspect is more of a clinical aspect, or more of what we encounter as problems given by the mothers, rather than as an important exam topic. It is not commonly asked in your exams, but important in day-to-day concern. Okay, right. They are the problems during lactation. One is inverted nipples. Please remember, inverted nipples makes the process of attachment difficult. It's a fact you need to know. Now, what happens when the baby is not able to suck the nipples properly, okay, it can make the nipples to become sore nipples, okay. So that is why this has to be corrected. How you do this? This is with the help of this plastic syringe technique. This is with the help of this plastic syringe technique. What do? You cut the nozzle, okay, and you put the plunger on the side of that cut end, okay, and then you create a pressure to take out, okay, the retracted nipple. Okay, this is what we call it as a syringe correction of inverted nipple. It should be done by the mother herself, right? Second is sore nipple. What is the important reason for sore nipple? The most important reason is improper latching or improper positioning and attachment. Now, what happens if the mother is not correctly positioning the baby? What happens? The baby will start sucking only from the nipple instead of sucking from the nipple and the areola. Why this is important? Because areola contains lot of milk, and the baby sucking from the areola, the baby will get lot of milk naturally. But if the baby is sucking only from the nipple because of improper attachment, what happens? The baby will get less milk. So the baby's thirst and the hunger will not be satisfied. So what does the baby do? The baby will start sucking vigorously. During this process, the mother is going to develop sore nipple. So the only treatment of sore nipple she may require is correct positioning and attachment of the baby to the breast. Second thing what they are telling is that after breastfeeding is over, some of the hind milk, okay, some drops of the hind milk is applied to the nipple, and the nipple should be air dry for some time. Okay, it is something like healing process. Okay, in between the feeding time, she has to air dry the nipple so that it is allowed to heal. Okay, right. Next important point is breast engorgement. Okay, this typically happens on day 2 to day 3. Why? Because by day 2 to day 3, the breast milk production increases. By the time, suppose the breastfeeding is not completely established, what will happen is the mother will have engorgement of the breast, where the breast becomes swollen and little bit harder. Okay. Sometimes what happen, it can progress on to inflammation. Okay. This is due to infection, where in addition to engorgement, the breast will become tender as well as more warm. Okay. This is called as a mastitis. This is called as mastitis. And remember, in case of mastitis, in addition to pain relieving medication like analgesics, you also have to add antibiotics. Very, very important point. And they can ask you the question, what is a common infection encountered in this group? It is commonly due to staphylococcus infection, commonly staphylococcus aureus. So that is why the penicillin group of antibiotics will be helpful. Whereas if it is only breast engorgement, what are you going to give? You are going to give analgesics as well as local warmth in the form of warm packs, warm water packs. That is what you are going to give. But if it is mastitis, definitely antibiotics are recommended. That should be remembered. The next one is even more dangerous, which is called as a breast abscess. Now, what happens if the mastitis or the engorged breast is not treated properly, then breast abscess formation can occur eventually. In this condition, the mother is going to have high grade fever, WBC count will be elevated, ESR will be high, CRP will be positive. Okay, right. And for this condition, definitely it's an abscess. So abscess definitely requires incision and drainage. In addition, mother also has to be given antibiotics. Please remember, these are the problems which are encountered during lactation. Now, one important point which I would want you to remember, they can ask in the exams, is if any of these problems are encountered, do you want to stop breastfeeding? Absolutely no. Breastfeeding has to continue. The mother may have some difficulty in direct breastfeeding. However, she can express the breast milk and give it to her baby. Under no point breastfeeding should be interrupted because of any of these problems I have told till this time. The last aspect about this breast milk is storage of expressed breast milk. Very often questions are asked from this section, so please make a note of it. Expressed breast milk can be stored at the room temperature for 6 to 8 hours. After that, there is a high chance of bacterial contamination. In refrigerator for a maximum of 24 hours. And in freezer at minus 20 degrees centigrade for 3 months. One very last point about this is something which is very important. An initiative of WHO and UNICEF, which is called as a World Breastfeeding Week. It is only in this month, but it was in the early part of this month. What is that? First week of August. Okay. First week of August, it was celebrated. Every year it is being celebrated. And for 2020, this year, the theme is jointly given by WHO and UNICEF, support breastfeeding for a healthier planet. So that concludes the session on breastfeeding. I have tried to cover the important points, theoretical points, as well as from the MCQ point. I have tried to cover in a shortest possible way. Hope you like this video. Please share with your friends. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to this channel and don't forget to press on the bell icon to get notified of the new videos as and when they are posted to this channel. Thank you and have a good day.